When Jimmy Carter left the presidency, he was only 56 years of age, one of the younger former presidents. And he did not want to retire. He wanted to keep busy, to do things for the rest of his life. The first thing he did on coming back to Georgia and coming back to Plains was write his presidential memoirs and then get to work on establishing a center and a library for his post-presidency. So after a year, he came to an agreement with Emory University that he would be university distinguished professor there, and in cooperation with Emory, establish the Carter Center. This would be an institution that would deal with conflict resolution, but with all other issues of peace and human rights throughout the world. At first, he wanted to focus mostly on global affairs, on issues such as peace in the Middle East and arms control. But as time went on, he established a program, an active program, called Global 2000 to bring healthcare to underdeveloped worlds. There were diseases that were not being treated. President Carter felt the Carter Center should not do what other organizations do, but should fill gaps, should fill vacuums. And so he looked for things that others were not doing or not doing well. And there were tropical diseases which were not being treated well throughout the world. In fact, one was a disease called Guinea worm. And the Carter Center in 1986 took on a campaign to eradicate Guinea worm. And to take on Guinea worm was an enormous challenge because there were about 3.5 million cases known throughout the world. But the Carter Center started working on this, and we knew how to eradicate it, because if it could be cut off in one small community, it was gone. And so we worked village by village. And in 2015, it had been reduced from 3.5 million cases to 22 cases. And the Carter Center is continuing to work on this. And our goal is to eradicate this disease from the earth. Diseases. But we've also worked on areas of peace as well. And President Carter in the early years would lead our delegations to work on election monitoring, first in Panama and in other places in Latin America, and then in places throughout the world. And as of 2016, the Carter Center has done more than 100 election monitoring missions. We've continued to work also in conflict resolution, working in places like Haiti, North Korea, Sudan, numerous other places where President Carter has gone in and worked with the sides to try to talk them into peace. He also has been an active author. He has now written, as of 2016, 29 books. And in 2006, he was elected to the Georgia Writers Hall of Fame. As a former president, he's won numerous awards. The most prominent was the Nobel Peace Prize in 2002, which he won for his efforts for peace and for his efforts on behalf of the Carter Center. He also and Mrs. Carter won the Presidential Medal of Freedom, which is the highest award given to a civilian in the United States. He's received numerous honorary degrees and other awards and is given great honor throughout the United States and the world.